Well, this year's event is the second annual. It was really initiated by the Oak Park River Forest Community Foundation with a number of partners, including the YMCA, Housing Forward, 10,000 Villages, RSVP, a volunteer program at Triton College, and the Oak Park Public Library. And this takes place at the library, and it is going to be on April 26th between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. We're going to be continuing to use the Veterans Room where it took place last year, but we're also going to be in the Community Room down on the first floor. We expect it will be even more fun than last year.
Well, I have to tell you that I can attest to it being more fun than last year, because this year we're going to be there with our cameras. We are going to be there, the Doris Davenport Show, and we'll also be there with our partners, GreatLocalShops.com, Ed Pitts and John Roberts, who of course is the owner of Pern's Office Supply. So we're real excited, because what we're going to do is to help to highlight many of the organizations that are there, and we're going to interview them on the floor and in the different spaces. We'll have something set up where they can come and we can feature them. Isn't the West Cook YMCA a lead sponsor?
Yes, they are.
This year, right? Yes. And who are some of the other sponsors for the program? You've got Housing Forward.
Housing Forward, 10,000 Villages, the Symphony of Oak Park Root Forest, RSVP of West Suburban and Southern DuPage Counties.
Right, that's right. And these are wonderful organizations. And these are organizations that will help develop the event. And they, what they'll do is match individual needs, match individual interests and skills with the nonprofit organization that needs their help, right? So how many nonprofits are there registered?
45.
All of these different areas. So now, tell us, how does the volunteer meet and match work?
The not-for-profits will have tables at the library, and they'll have information about what their organization provides and the skill requirements that they're looking for. And potential volunteers can go, they can meet, and then if they're interested, sign up in order to get involved in forwarding the causes that they really care about. Many people have already registered, and some of the volunteers are trying to match up and say, oh, these are the organizations you might want to meet with that day. It was so popular. It was more popular than we could have imagined.
It was very, as a volunteer who actually went to the event last year, I was very impressed with the amount of people that were there to help, to help the community out by volunteering. So.
It was great.
So now, what's nice is that when people go around to the different exhibits, what they're going to do is have a conversation with the representative that's there representing that particular organization. And so they'll have a discussion. And you know, I'm all about the story. So whatever transpires in that story experience between the two really is going to depend on the organization. So it'll be based on the description of the mission, what their impact is as a nonprofit, what kind of volunteer job descriptions they're looking for. Some of them may even have the job descriptions for volunteers right there at the exhibit. So this is a real mix and match. They want to make sure, and I know I always say mix and match, but it's meet and match.
Meet.
So they'll be able to actually give you the necessary skills and qualifications that they're looking for. And we know that these organizations here in Oak Park and River Forest, they're seeking a wide range of volunteers. When you talk about 40 organizations that are going to be discussing their mission, their work, their needs, there's a potential for almost 300 volunteers to end up taking advantage of this. Now, Carla, let me ask you, what were some of the benefits that nonprofits stated last year?
That it was a well-run, one-stop shop for volunteerism, so people didn't have to go to each different organization. They could just go to one spot and find all of the organizations who were looking for volunteers. Mm-hmm. That the volunteers were getting the word out about their agency. Mm-hmm. It was a very well-run, organized event.
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of networking going on, new volunteers that were not familiar with any of the organizations. They could learn about them at the event. Mm-hmm. They loved the, coming to the library for the venue, and then very diverse audience and a lot of different opportunities.
Well, some of the results were that organizations found that they had an opportunity to meet with very many people. Mm-hmm. And the numbers showed that each organization that was there spoke to an average of 35 people. Mm-hmm. And these were people they may not have had an opportunity to meet otherwise. They had a chance to tell their story. And even if you don't make a match, you still get to tell your story and popularize your organization.
Right.
There's so many organizations doing really good work that need more publicity, and they need more people knowing about what they do.
Yeah.
This event really pushes that out there for the whole public to know about.
That's awesome.
And then we know that if you have a good experience, and I think most people who came to this had a really good experience, they tell other people about the stories that they listened to and that they learned. Mm-hmm. So this spreads throughout the community, and I think that was the wonderful thing about last year. And then, of course, there were opportunities where people actually got involved with an organization like Carla.
That's right, because Carla, you were actually recruited from an organization that participated last year, isn't that right?
I was.
Tell us about it.
Yes.
That was good, Jim.
Good lead-in, right?
Oh, wait, did I mention we had two guest hosts?
All about the segue.
So I've done a lot of volunteering throughout my career. I'm a single parent, so for the last 7 or so years, I've not done a whole lot in the community, but because I'm a single parent, but my son is 14 now, so I can kind of get out there. Anyway, so I wanted to do something, I wanted to volunteer, and when I saw the ad in the newspaper, I thought, oh, that would be a great event for me to go to. So I registered online, and I was able to see what organizations were there, and they also had them listed what they were looking for in their volunteers. So 10,000 Villages was looking for somebody with marketing and events background, of which I have that. So I specifically went to the event to speak to 10,000 Villages. So when I got there, they were like the first table I saw, and I headed over. And it was a great connection, and kind of just how it happened. A couple of weeks later, they had an orientation for everybody who came to the event, and so we got a chance to tour the store and find out a little bit more about it.
Mm-hmm. Organizations reported that it was very valuable to them to participate, and in that four-hour period, you know, they met more people than some of them had met in 2 months previously.
One of the things we learned from Kristen is the national study that was done about volunteerism around the country. We discovered that there's more volunteering that takes place in Oak Park than almost anywhere else, and certainly the numbers are hugely different from how much we volunteer here in Oak Park than even our neighbors in Chicago. But make sure that you, April 26th on your calendar, or until 8 p.m., and it's going to take place at the Oak Park Public Library. It is going to be the place to be. So this is not just the type of an event where we ask organizations to come and then ask people who are interested to come and volunteer. There's some science behind how this is actually put together, and they've done a lot of homework to put this together and make it just as valuable for you as we know once you put your time it will be for the organizations that you meet and match up with. Carla, what motivated you to pick 10,000 Villages?
Have you been to their store?
I was in there just the other day to put your poster up.
I love the store. I love the merchandise in the store. I love the fact that it is fair trade and it helps artisans from developing countries to earn a living.
Mm-hmm.
The merchandise is handmade, mm-hmm. or it's recycled. Connecting with the women,
uh-huh.
that work in the store, connecting with the different committees that they have. I've been involved with recruitment.
Mm-hmm.
So we have volunteer meetings every month where, you know, we get to network with each other and play games and have fun, and we get a discount at the store.
That's actually pretty nice, because when you talk about fair trade, it's usually fair trade among third world countries, and one of the big things in these third world countries is networking among women.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very interesting that is one of the things that's highlighted for you as a personal benefit.
Right.
I think that's pretty fantastic. Do you have a favorite memory so far?
A favorite memory?
Yeah.
Other than when I got hit in the head with
the... in the head with the wall.
At least you remember it.
I was going to say.
With an easel.
With an easel.
I was doing a presentation on volunteerism and recruitment, and we were putting up the easel and I got hit in the head.
Oh, my goodness.
But since I've been volunteering there, I started out with marketing. And then there was a need for recruitment to get additional volunteers working in the store. And the marketing and recruitment kind of goes hand in hand together. So I got involved with recruitment. then I was instrumental in putting together 10,000 Villages with the One Earth Film Festival.
Mm-hmm.
And the most recent accomplishment is that I am a board member and will be their treasurer.
Oh, wonderful. Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. And Jim, how does your role as host, because that's a really, really big role, how does your role as host for the Volunteer Meet and Match event fit with your overall strategic goal for the library?
Well, that's a great question, of course. And the Oak Park Public Library has three overarching strategic goals: engagement, learning, and stewardship.
Mm-hmm.
And we believe that this is absolute direct engagement with the community, in order to both partner with other organizations,
mm-hmm.
but also to invite community members who wish to volunteer into our library. And so that, you know, that addresses the engagement, but the stewardship is also very important. And volunteers, you know, really is, volunteers make a great contribution to organizations and ended up saving us money,
mm-hmm.
and enabling us to do more with limited resources.
Mm-hmm. We would like to thank all of you for being here. And what is the one thing you want to remind people about for this upcoming event? Both of you, please. Your elevator pitch.
make sure you go with a purpose. You know what you want to do. You know what you're passionate about. I think that's always helpful, because then that way you show up. Instead of just going there and signing up and then never getting involved, if you're passionate about something, you are going to show up and actually volunteer.
All right. Jim?
The thing I would stress to people is that although the volunteer is giving, the volunteer gets a great deal as well. And they get to feel like they're contributing to the community. They get camaraderie. From other volunteers and staff at the organization that they mm-hmm. are linked up with.
Great. Well, we want to thank you all for coming in and visiting with us and letting everybody know about the Volunteer Meet and Match that's going to be taking place on April 26th at the Oak Park Public Library. We want everybody to take advantage of this, put it on your calendars. It's going to be a great event starting at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and it will run until 8 p.m. There is parking available underneath of the library. And at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, you should be able to find neighborhood parking because it may overflow, which we're hoping happens. And so listen, thank you. We're excited. We'll be there representing the Doris Davenport Show with GreatLocalShops.com. So come. You may be interviewed that day.